Good morning, everybody. Yesterday, we started multiplying with the method FOIL, the FOIL method. Okay. Most of you look like it did well, but some of you still have problems. Yesterday we multiply two binomial expression and we had the coefficient or the coefficient of the variable in both binomial was only one. Right now the coefficient of the variable is going to be different of one. Okay. Then to start doing FOIL, that means F for the first terms, O for the outer size, I for the inner side, and L for the last term. Okay, so when I go with FOIL with the F for the first term. Okay. That means that is the first F is the product of the first term of my binomial. Okay. That means 3x times 2a. That means 3 times 2. X tan X. It's coming here O for the outer side. That should be the outer side should be this part here. That should be 3x times 9, should be 3 times 9 times x. If you multiply positive, then positive is going to be positive. And now I, coming for the inner side, that means that's the inner side. Inner, that should be outer, that should be first. Inner side, I mean you multiply is the product of the inner side to be A times 2, A times 2 times X. And the product of the sign should be positive. Then positive is going to be positive in this case. And the last is the coming L for the last term. That means the last term should be the last term of the binomial. This should be the last term of the other binomial. That means that's the product, the 8 times 9. What is the sign of this product here? It should be positive, then positive, positive. Because we have positive and positive, I know that all the signs here are going to be positive. You don't have that problem with the sign when they have positive and positive. Right now, I have to solve my problem here. 3 times 2 is 6. You know that x times x is x squared. Because when you multiply the variables here, what you have to add is exponent, because exponent should be here 1 and 1. You have to write the same variable and add the exponent. Mean you have here x times x should be x. The exponent of x is 1. The exponent of x is 1. When you multiply, you have to add the exponent. They're gonna be 2. That means that x squared. Just only in case that some of you do not remember this part. X squared plus 3 times 9, 27. X plus 8 times 2, 16 x plus 8 times 9, 72. Right now we have here like terms. That means that we have the same variable, x and x. That means these two terms you need to add. That means we have here, we are probably down 10 squared. We have to add 720 plus 16. How much 720 plus 16 to be 43. Plus 43x. And now we write it down to 72. That is the answer. Okay. That should be the answer. Yeah. 6 squared plus 43x. Plus 72. Okay. Me metas el folio. I'm going to do another example for. And here we have 5x a little down in order to do this. Okay, let's do. First, we need to multiply the first foil. The first, that means 5x times 2x. That means 5 times 2. Or if you want, remember parentheses, just only write parentheses, 5 times 2. X times x, x squared. Yes, I can write directly, okay? That should be 1st. The first term. And then other term. The other term should be 2 parts that being outer. Outer, the whole outer. Should be 5x plus 5x times 11. 5 times 11 times 8. The sign positive times positive is gonna be positive. Right now is coming the inner part. I for inner, that means the product of these two terms here. Should be 8 times 2, 16. Okay. 8 times 2, and 8 times 8. The sign is going to be negative times positive, negative. And the last one should be the last term. Last term are 8 times 11. 8 times 11. The sign of the last product here should be negative times positive. It's going to be negative. Along here we have 5 times 2, 10, 10 x squared. You have to add these two terms. Remember, you have like terms because they have the same variable in here. But because there are different signs, you have to take away. But first, we have here 55x. 5 times 11, 50 times 8, minus negative 16x. 5 times 2, 16. 8 times 11, 88. Okay. You have like 10. We write it down here, 10x squared. Positive 55x. Negative 16x, you have to take away 55. Take away 16, it's gonna be 39. 39x positive because the sign positive belongs to the bigger number, to 55. That one should be, you wrote it down, 88. Then our answer is going to be 10x squared plus 39x minus 88.